Oh my. Oh, wow. Look at that. This looks something out of like a movie.
Okay. I think this might be one of the most exciting episodes of Tabs because I've been saying for a while now that there are no custom or modded vehicle, or rather there's no unit created vehicles on the workshop. You guys have been telling me that I need to dig a little bit deeper. People have spawner tanks. Someone created a drone in Totally Accurate Battle Simulator. And like, say we just take out drone and we search units popularity, but then you have the stealth drone, assassin drones, Hulk busters, helicopters? How does a helicopter work? So before we get back into the action, this video is sponsored by Cookie Run Kingdom. Cookie Run Kingdom is the new prequel to the epic Cookie Run world, where you'll get to discover secrets of the Cookie World past. Now, if you haven't played the original, this is the perfect entrance to the series. If you love RPG, base building, and sim-based games, which as members of Baron's Brigade, I know you do, because I love them too, then you've got to pre-register for Cookie Run Kingdom, which comes out January 21st. It's the perfect mashup of those three styles all wrapped up in one game, with one of the most beautiful, and let's be honest, cute art styles that I've seen in years. In Cookie Run Kingdom, you're going to reclaim a lost ruined kingdom that you get to imagineer, build, and then fortify for cookies of all kinds. Everything in your kingdom is cookie themed, even the buildings, which kind of makes me a bit hungry. Beyond building the most epic and magically sweet kingdom, you'll get to collect cookies and unlock their powers through the gacha function to receive new cookies. Build a powerful cookie squad, bring them to battle, and adventure through over 200 story levels. So once again, a big shout out and thank you to Cookie Run Kingdom for sponsoring this video, and I highly recommend you check out and pre-register for the game, which is available on iOS and Android. Join the 2 million plus pre-registrants to enter your kingdom. Pre-register using the link in the description, and let's get back into the action. A railgun tank? Omega tank. I like how they have a real world picture. Razor tanks? Stealth bomber? I don't know how this is supposed to work. But if it does, I'm going to be so wildly impressed. Anti-tank gun? Well, with all the tank stuff, we're definitely going to need this. And we've got Star Wars Death Troopers? Yes. Okay. Someone build... How do you do this? The fact that people are doing this is just clearly saying that, like, we're both playing the unit creator, but we are not playing them in the same way. A hot air balloon? The Air Force is coming to Totally Accurate Battle Simulator today, guys. Oh my god, that snake looks great. We're gonna check that out. Cthulhu, you gotta be kidding me. So now we've gotta make a new faction, and this is Totally Accurate Vehicles, I think. And now we need to go try these out, because, I mean, let's just go to a nice, beautiful, open level, because we're gonna be doing some flight testing. It's like when the Wright brothers brought flight. It's like, I feel like this is... This is the Totally Accurate Battle Simulator version of that. Because, well, first I gotta see Cthulhu. Oh my god. All right, how does Cthulhu do against a bunch of cannons? Cthulhu looks really silly, and he must have a high mass because all these cannons were not able to knock him back. So it's a fun little boss unit here. But I wouldn't say he's great by any stretch of the imagination. Wait, you know what he is? Okay, it looks like, is he a Medusa? No, that's literally an octopus on the guy's head. So it's an octopus helmet. That's pretty funny. And he's got the Pharaoh ability and he's just destroying them. That's cool. Cthulhu's pretty funny. But now is the time to try out. And we've got so many things. We've got a stealth bomber. How does that work? Oh, you gotta be kidding me. You have got to be kidding me. All right, stealth bomber versus a bunch of swordy boys and fight. Oh my god, okay. This guy's got a ton of anti-aircraft. I think the best way to try to attack that is like, how would you shoot this down? Well, you get the Gatling guns for sure. And then you'd have a bunch of like various anti-aircraft installations. And then you would hope that they'd be able to just shoot it down, right? So he's $3,000. So I'm not entirely sure he's balanced. He's firing so many rockets. It's at such a high rate, the Gatling guns aren't even able to start firing. Now they're starting to crank up. So the plane doesn't fly around or anything. It must be a unit hovered. But how are people like, I don't know how they're doing it, but they are. And it's wild. I didn't know that was possible in this game. Can this thing even be shot down? Like, what happens if I take control of this? This is not going to go well. Oh my God, I see him. I see the guy now. He's hiding inside of it. Well, naturally, because you'd think there would be a pilot for a plane. But when the plane has eyes, you begin to wonder, wait a second, is there a pilot inside of it, or is the pilot the plane? And so eventually they take him out. So I guess he has a certain amount of shots he can
can fire? Why did he only fire some and then he stopped? So he fired a bunch of salvos and then there's about four left. And then he just doesn't fire again. Interesting. Okay. Well, that is the stealth bomber. Now, who wins? Stealth bomber Cthulhu? Let's actually find out. I mean, this is a question for the ages. All right, so if Cthulhu does show up, a dimensional horror of some kind, you know what? Just send in the stealth bombers. Now, let's see. We've got a death trooper here from Star Wars. And when you zoom out, you can't really see their colors. See, this looks like a dude with like, and then you get closer, boom. Okay, they look pretty good. And you're a little short for a stormtrooper, aren't you? Now, how do you do against troopers? All right, so we're going to put a lot of snakes in here. All right, fire the snakes already. They dodged them. These guys have an incredible firepower. You're just snake archers. I thought that was like a snake, like an actual snake unit, but alas, it is not. So some of these are wildly creative and others are just a little bit tricky. Now let's find out, how do you make, oh God, a helicopter? Okay, when you get closer, it's, I mean, is the Tabs community not the best community there is? Oh, I can see a minigun. Oh God. Okay, and we're not gonna have them test against death troopers. I want to see them against a bunch of sortie boys. So it's roughly equal. And we could take it off to make it a little bit more even. Okay. Oh, this one actually flies around a little bit. He's got a minigun and rockets. So he's kind of like an Apache here. Why isn't the minigun firing? It's looking at them. Look at that. Ominously. Oh, there we go. Okay. Okay. Now, you know those stories or, you know, imaginative tales. It's like, what would happen if modern weaponry went back in time and then like had to have a battle? Who would win? An Apache or a bunch of archers? Well, I think we know the answer to that. But the question is, who would win in Totally Accurate Battle Simulator? Well, clearly the Apache gets shot down by arrows because there's just health bars. There's no damage models, right? There's no armor that could deflect it. You just have a special ability that would allow you to deflect things. How would he do against some Chuko News? Because Chuko News, one of my favorite units in the game, pretty good fire rate. And that's about even. 2100 versus 2140. Oh, was that a friendly fire accident? It looks like it was. He's got one sticking out of his thigh. So one of the crossbow bolts from the Chukonu. Now, you've got him surrounded, but he's just picking everybody off with a single rocket. Oh, and he's dodging. Okay, so the Apache helicopter, which kind of looks like a weird flying whale mixed with a black sheep and one of those little twirly hats. Oh, that's what it is. That's what it is. So check this out. So if we go to the main menu and we go to workshop, or rather custom content, and we were to build a unit, if we were to try to make a new unit and give him a hat. Oh my God, there's fidget spinners. Now we're gonna have that helicopter. Helicap. See? People are making it out of this. Now, how are they manipulating the shape of it? That is what I don't know. I don't know how they're doing it, but they are. And it is blowing my mind. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. And we haven't even gotten to zeppelins yet. All right, what's an Omega tank? Oh, he's got an invisible gun barrel. How do you do that? What? All right, the Omega tank has a lightsaber noodle sticking out, and he just doesn't stop. Okay, now we have to try some anti-tank, and I think one of the best ways is just tons of cannons. Everybody fire the cannons. Boom. All right, he's named Omega, but he was able to be taken out. He was just had to be taken out by what? $24,000 of pirate artillery. Now, what if he was to go up against swordcasters, for example? Is he able to defend against this many sword projectiles coming in? Probably, right? He's not a real tank. He doesn't have a damage model. Actually, wow. That's pretty incredible. All right, and then if we just test him against archers, like who wins there? I think the Omega tank will win. It's just super weird. And he's got the soldier sitting on the back, like the Vietnam era guy with an M16 just blapping away at everybody. So the Omega tank is cool. And then you have a railgun tank and a spawner tank. Wait a minute. That's a dude with a tank barrel. And he fires a treasure chest. How is that a spawner tank? There's no tank, it's just a tank barrel. I think that, is this a glitch? Because the spawner tank is clearly pretty good. He looks like he's only summoning in pirate faction units. Let's test that, actually. So we'll do spawner tank versus spawner tank. Who wins? My bet's on spawner tank, but if they both just summon in pirates... Oh, I guess they are pirate treasure chests, right? Interesting. I feel like you could let this one play for, like, an hour, and it might not end, because the spawner tank would have to be taken out. And are either of them in vulnerable positions? Wait a minute. I think the one on the left stopped firing. The one on the right's still alive, so maybe the battles wouldn't take an hour. Clearly. Let's see. How long will this take? It shouldn't take too long. There's a harpooner in the back, but he's probably about to be defeated. And one of the pirate captains is calling in like this cannon barrage, a cannonade, and blue wins. Not even in a minute. Okay, so we've seen some incredible stuff. Helicopters, Cthulhus, Omega tanks, railgun tanks. It's time to see the drone. So this must be the first drone, and it's $500, right? So he's flying in shooting a bullet straight down? All right, what is he made out of? It looks like hats. How do you put the hats like that? And then, what is that? It looks like something out of, it looks like something out of Half-Life. But when you pause time and let it go, weird stuff happens. I feel like we need more drones. So we'll put in a couple. And by a couple, I mean we've got like 8 or 10 out there. And they just kind of hover, but they hover relatively close to the ground. Oh my God. Now, we've got to see, is this the most popular drone? Because presumably, this is what I would think. If it's one of the most popular and downloaded things on the workshop, then it's got to be one of the best ones, right? Unless there's some hooliganism afoot, then the credibility of the workshop rating is in question. So the drones are pretty cool. Let's actually see. I want to see if there's more, though. Yeah, the stealth drone is the first one. Then there's the assassin, the SWAT drone. There's another stealth drone by Agors. But now that everyone's seen how it's done, right? But it's got 2,300 subscribers. Obi-Wan Kenobi. Oh my God, someone made Siren Head? I gotta see this. I gotta see just how good it is. All right, so we've got good old Siren Head. Now, how good is he? He's decent. It's just braided hair. But this goes to show you the creativity of the Tabs community, the fact that this was even done. So we're gonna send in the drones. Like, what do you do when fighting Siren Head? How about sending the drones? Siren Head can fly, I guess. And the drones, I think, only shoot downwards. Wow, I don't know what happened with that explosion, but it worked. But maybe, so drones aren't, maybe you send in like a few scout drones. You have a helicopter and then you have this anti-tank gun. Oh, this is interesting. The anti-tank gun, it lost all of its barrels. Oh my, it's definitely a railgun, isn't it? I can't even see the drones anymore. I think they were all wiped out. Oh God, now Siren Head's going after the anti-tank gun. So let's try a railgun tank as well. Send in the modern military to take out Siren Head. Remember when we made the, did we make it or did it haunt my game? Wink, wink. The Siren Head mod way back in the day. It was so cool because at the time it was something that like had never, there was nothing in Tabs like it. There was no mod like, oh my God, he just chucked that helicopter. That helicopter gone. So, and that's a blue victory. That's a victory for this guy. Okay, so Siren Head might just be a little bit invincible. But really though, the things I'm still the most excited for are like hot air balloons. What are these? They look like teacups. And this has got to be a hat, right? Is this a hat? This is like a Da Vincian inventor. Is this a soup bowl? I don't know. We're gonna have like primitive people. Primitive humans from the past meet Da Vincian style hot air balloons, which are now just, I think that was their death animation. Oh, they threw a bomb. Oh, they can actually throw bombs. Okay, then they die. So what if we didn't do ranged? What if we didn't do ranged, right? To try to get a better idea of what happens exactly when they do fight. So these guys drop the bombs. And they can't hit him because they're hovering. How did they get the hover distance like that? This is incredible. This is the Da Vinci style battle. But what happens if a hot air balloon meets a ballooner from the Renaissance faction? So here they are. All right, ballooners, get to it. Grab them and take them up to the high heavens. Can you do it? They jump and they're trying to grab it. Somehow they flipped it and it's still holding on. Oh my God, the meteorite abilities. I don't know how this is happening. It's wildly impressive though. So you see it from a distance. It doesn't look brown and it doesn't even look like that shape. But when you get closer, it does. I mean, someone is a genius. Hot air balloons are really cool, but imagine if they had like musketeers in them. I mean, if Landfall ever allows us to have better custom vehicles, because look at what people are doing without being able to do that. And now I think it's time for Led Zeppelin, the big airship himself. And we'll just have it against a bunch of clubbers. Oh my. Oh wow. Look at that. This looks something out of like a movie. Okay, so he absolutely destroyed everything. Zeppelin airships in Totally Accurate Battle Simulator. Air forces. I mean, we'll have skeleton archers because you know what? Giant zeppelins. Like what we learned from the Hindenburg was explosive gas is explosive. All we gotta do is light it on fire. Guys, all you have to do is light it on fire. Start lighting on fire. Oh my God, he's burning the inside of that. And look, there's those dang spinning hats again, man. Yeah, this might be one of the best ones yet. I mean, this is nuts. Ooh, you know what we need? I think we need to try out some ballistas. And you know what? Maybe catapults too. They might have a better firing arc. All right, guys. Fire arrows, catapults, and ballistas. Like, if you lived in the past and you had to try to destroy a zeppelin, I would imagine you'd try these things. Okay, so ballistas just wiped it out. Now, we know ballistas are really good, and they do high damage. I wonder if catapults will do anything to it. One of them just got wiped out. Let's see. All three of them did survive. All right.
He's getting hit with giant stones. I mean, zeppelins should not be very strong. Come on, guys. Oh, wow. Yeah, he wipes you out, man. If you cannot beat him early, he will destroy you. Okay. Okay. I mean, guys, the modding community is just nuts. What happens if Zeppelin fights Zeppelin? Red versus blue Zeppelin, who wins? The rocket barrage, man. It is so good. There's got to be more, right? Okay. Kirov airship. No way. It's got the guy. Oh my God. Don't tease me like this. Air balloon. Here it is. Oh, Agors. Can I search Agors? Just so many drones. You can tell that the drones, just someone saw one, just like me, and it just blew everybody's mind. And so everyone's like, you know what? I'm going to make something like that too. And I think you can edit them. Charizard. Oh, we got Pokemons. No way. Oh, man. Whoa. Luke in an X-Wing? Okay, that looks silly. Yeah, I guess if we search helicopter, there's an assortment of them, but these ones are definitely the best. So all of these vehicles and Cthulhu, we have to find a way to beat these. And I'm wondering if we can put in a super peasant. If a super peasant can beat Cthulhu, I'm sorry, but I don't think a super peasant can do it. So we'll give him a dark peasant friend. And let's see if these guys can... Wait a minute. How did the super peasant die? He flies in. What kills him? I'm sorry, but what is killing the super peasant? All right, here he is now. He's flying in the air. He just got hit with a flurry of rockets by both the stealth bomber and the blimp. Did he get launched off the map? Blue victory again? Okay, we're gonna need the alliance here. The last alliance. Thor, the wizard, all of the special units versus the new bad guys, because that is exactly what they are, man. We need... Oh, man. Will this be enough, you think? All right. They have a chance, but you got to remember that that's a spawner tank out there. I think the Air Force and some of the more, you know, creepy things like Siren Head are just too powerful. Although, I guess balance was brought back. We have victory here for the good guys. And that was able to defeat them. So even Cthulhu and Siren Head went down. Oh, man. No way. No way. It just blows my mind that this stuff is achievable. The creativity of people is just well and above beyond even my imagination. Did I think anyone was ever going to be able to create a helicopter or a drone without being able to bring in outside materials, just using whatever you had in-game? I mean, just some of the most talented people I've ever met in my life. Now, can Dark Peasant beat Cthulhu? I don't know, man. I don't know how much health Cthulhu has. I don't know how he got destroyed last time. Oh, that's probably how. He flew off the map. I can't even see the perimeter there. You can just see his legs. All right, who's left alive? A death trooper. One death trooper. You want to know how powerful they were? Oh, and then he fell. That was a very dramatic death, right? So anyway, guys, thank you for watching another episode of Totally Accurate Battle Simulator. This one was just probably the wildest and weirdest one we've ever seen. And make sure to check out the Cookie Run Kingdom. A big shout out and thank you to our sponsor for today. The link is in the video description below. And remember that I am going to be playing it over on the mobile channel, Baron Von Tactics. So go on over there, hit the subscribe button, check out the game. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in the next video.